It's Toon Talk Thursday, and Papa Keith from 103.5 The Beat is here to give us all the latest in the R&B music scene. The Counting Crows are coming to the Hard Rock, and we talked to the lead singer all about it. Plus, summer is officially here, and it's the time to protect our skin from that South Florida sun. A dermatologist gives us tips on how to maintain a healthy and glowing skin. You don't want to miss it. South Florida Live starts right now. Thursday on South Florida Live. I'm your host, Kristen Sanchez, and we got a great show in store for you today. But first, I do want to start with an exciting twist to share with all the fans, because I know there's a lot of you of The Voice that will have you on the edge of your seats. Listen to this. Coming season of The Voice is going to look a whole lot different, and not just because Coach Blake Shelton retired. This show is going to introduce a new double chair, which is going to consist of two red spinning chairs that say, "We want you." Okay, that's a change from the "I want you." So no word yet on if they are going to bring any duos or, you know, what this exactly all means, but fans are speculating. What do you think? Okay, it is now time for Toon Talk right now. Papa Keith is in the building.
Yeah.
You know, a few days ago, I was in your building, but now
yes.
You're in mine.
And
so
congratulations.
Yes.
I love all of this.
Thank you. Welcome to my home here on South Florida Live. I'm excited to have you because you got some really great stuff coming up. First, I want to talk about Lil Durk, though, really making some waves right now.
Yeah, so he has this single out right now with J. Cole, All My Life. We love it. It's just like feel-good hip-hop.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Coming off of his album Almost Healed, and I'm just really excited for that, and I'm really excited for him and for hip-hop, you know?
I was reading all about it. So his album dropped on the 26th, and mm-hmm. really what everyone's talking about right now is the verse with J. Cole. That
yes.
took 2 years
yes.
to do.
Yes, it did. It did. But like all good things, we gotta wait sometimes, right?
I mean, that's a really long wait, but it was worth it because everyone's
Definitely.
Talking about it. So it's called All My Life with J. Cole. 2 years, and that is what has fans really just wanting more. They can't get enough of it.
Yes, yes, and I'm loving it. Every
yeah.
bit of it.
Number 5 on the Billboard Hot 100. So that's pretty cool.
Absolutely. Big ups to Durk.
And then also want to talk about BET Awards. That's happening on Sunday, and Papa Keith is going to be on a flight tonight, going to LA. He's doing all the cool stuff there. What exactly are you going to be doing in LA?
Well, we're going to be hitting the radio room on Friday and Saturday, so you'll be able to hear me broadcasting
yes.
on 103.5 The Beat. Also get to interview some of the biggest artists in hip-hop and R&B right now, and get to check out the show on Sunday.
Which
yeah.
is going to be awesome. So you're doing like a speed dating with all the best artists in the biz.
Pretty much.
And of course, we want to mention Uncle Luke.
Yes, we have to. So they're doing a 50th year celebration of hip hop, and it would not be 50 years of hip hop without mentioning Uncle Luke, you know, the godfather of Southern rap, man. So I'm excited to see him perform in that tribute.
Okay, let's bring it back home, though, because we can't forget about all things happening in South Florida, which is always the coolest things, like Rolling Loud, which is going to be awesome this year.
It is going to be awesome. This 3-day mega hip-hop festival is coming to town July 21st through the 23rd, and we are so excited about it. We got artists like Lil Uzi Vert, Travis Scott, who's always a big Rolling Loud favorite, and we're also going to have ASAP Rocky performing live and many other artists.
Yeah, I mean, it's hip-hop's biggest festival, and it's right here in our own backyard, which is awesome. Rolling Loud, always so much fun. So again, happening, like you said, July 21st, and you actually interviewed the co-CEO of Rolling Loud. Talk to me
yeah,
about that.
Sharif, he yeah, Sharif. He came by 103.5 The Beat, and I just asked him, like, what is your thought process when you have these artists performing and stuff like that? So we chopped it up. He brought his new artists in for me to interview as well. And it was just an amazing interview. So I want everybody to check that out when they get a chance.
Yeah, so that's on your YouTube, right?
It is.
On your social pages. I took a peek at it. I mean, you got all the good stuff on
yes.
there. So we can't forget about that. By the way, Papa Keith is giving you so much more because he has tickets to go to Rolling Loud that you can win. You just got to listen,
right? Let me correct you. We
okay.
have the most tickets.
The most most tickets.
The most tickets to see Rolling Loud, all right?
So that means you got to tune in, listen to Papa Keith, and of course, Miami's number one station for hip hop, R&B, all the good stuff. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
They got me running right now. Attention, rock fans. The Counting Crows are flying into South Florida, and the band will be performing this summer at the Hard Rock Live. You know, that's where we find our very own Miriam right now. Hey, they're looking great inside the Hard Rock right there in Hollywood. I heard that you spoke to the lead singer, Adam Duritz. What's the scoop, Miriam?
I did, Kristen. And you know what? Before we get there, just 90s rock hits different. And you know, lucky for us here in South Florida, Counting Crows fans, they're coming to the Hard Rock Live here at Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino here in Hollywood. And I had the chance to talk to Adam Duritz. You know, he talks about his latest album, plus what he's most excited for this upcoming tour.
Think has been the secret or the key to keeping your band alive for the last 30 years?
I'm a great band leader. I'm really good at it. Now, you know, I think I've made it a priority over other things. I think that I realized really early on that I loved being in this band. And so, you know, there's always things that you could want or things that seem important, but to me, what made me happy was being in this band. You know, and I realized early on I just wanted to stay in it. And I think I've made that the first priority forever.
We've seen a resurgence of the 90s nowadays. Now, would you say you found a new generation of fans attracted to your music?
I mean, it seems to always happen that, like, you know, when I was a kid, the 60s were big, and then the 70s weren't cool, and then a little while later, the 70s were cool, and the 80s weren't cool, and then it was the 80s, and now it's the 90s. That just seems to be like, pop culture likes to look back a little bit, hate it, and a little bit further and love it.
I want to talk a little bit about one of your best singles, Mr. Jones, because when you were starting out, you were dreaming of fame. What would you tell your younger self now, looking back?
Well, nice job nailing it. Yeah. I had no fame at that point, nothing but like dreams of it, and I think I portrayed it, you know, pretty clearly, just from my imagination. You know, and it's an interesting song to sing because I wrote it at a time when I hadn't experienced any of that stuff. And it was about dreaming about being a rock star, but also about realizing that it probably wasn't going to be everything you dreamed about. And then it was interesting to actually live it as well.
Tell me more about your inspiration behind the album Butter Miracle Sweet One.
I got really intrigued with the idea of writing a suite of music where you had four songs that all flowed together like one long song. And I just was really kind of interested in the challenge of composing it and the difficulty of recording it. I really got excited about the possibilities.
You're back on tour and you're coming back to the States. What are you most excited about?
Well, hopefully seeing some friends. You know, last time we toured, we were really in a strict bubble because of COVID. And I think we'll be able to open that up a little bit now. That's probably the biggest thing is, you know, you make a lot of friends over the years. You don't see them all the time, but you do get to see them when you tour. And it's a really nice thing.
You know, Adam talked about friends. Yeah, they're bringing Dashboard Confessional to the tour. So if you want tickets, you can head on over to myhrl.com. Coming to you from Hollywood, I'm Miriam Tapia, South Florida Live. And Kristen, you know, Accidentally in Love, amazing song. Amazing song, my fave.
Watching your story reminded me of all the great hits that they have. And there's one night to see it, folks. August 5th, Hard Rock Live at 8 o'clock. You don't want to miss it. Miriam, thank you. Hey, there's still so much more to come here on South Florida Live. You know, with officially a summer officially underway, there's a few things that you need to know.
So it's really important to protect year-round, particularly when you're in the sun here like we are in Miami.
Don't miss out on these skincare tips from a local dermatologist that will get you prepared and ready to face the South Florida sun. I'll stand under those umbrellas and I might take a picture too. You know, that's exactly what the City Place Doral wants you to do as they are embracing the stormy weather and bringing a burst of spring to its surrounding. They've created the perfect Instagram-worthy moment. It's an art installation that doubles as a picturesque backdrop. We're talking 1,300 colored umbrellas, all the colors creating just a stunning view there that's being begged to share on social. So if you do snap a pic, a selfie, whatever it may be, make sure to tag City Place Doral and use the hashtag umbrellas over City Place Doral, and you'll have a chance to have your photo featured on their page. You know, with the scorching heat of summer upon us, it's important to keep our skin protected and, of course, always looking healthy. So we do want to bring you expert advice on getting your skin summer ready with essential tips on sunscreen and moisturizer. So I sat down, I talked to dermatologist Dr. Roberta Del Campo at her office in North Miami to see what we can do to best take care of our skin.
That daily sun protection is important because as the sun continues to hit our skin, it damages the skin. So it causes these abnormal cells that can eventually lead to skin cancer, but also signs of photoaging. So it's really important to protect year-round, particularly when you're in the sun here like we are in Miami.
The first essential step, according to Dr. Del Campo, is sunscreen.
A minimum of SPF 30, and that's really frankly because we typically only apply about one half to one third of what we should be applying. What's important about a mineral-based sunblock is it actually reflects the sunlight. We have chemical sunscreens, they screen or filter the sunlight, but you're still getting a huge amount of UV rays. Mineral-based sun protection actually block and they force the sun rays to bounce off of the skin.
Dr. Del Campo says it should be applied daily, even on cloudy days, as the sun's rays could still come through the clouds. Apply it generously to all exposed areas. So that means your face, neck, arms, and legs. Reapply every 2 hours or even more frequently if you're swimming or sweating.
Many of us don't want to use things with like zinc or titanium dioxide because it can look white. When you rub it in, it actually absorbs completely and you don't have a white film on the skin.
Although the humidity levels may be higher during summer, it doesn't mean our skin doesn't require hydration. So let's talk moisturizers.
If you're looking for more of a hydrating, more intense hydrating product, you can actually layer on something that has, again, hyaluronic acid, but it has squalene, which is a non-comedogenic type of product. It also has ceramides, which we talked about are important to moisturize. What's nice about this lotion is it comes in a pump form. And it's light. Again, everything in the summer is light.
And don't forget to protect your lips.
So you can apply this, it's a sunblock, but it also moisturizes the skin. So you can use it as like an Aquaphor-ish during the day with sun protection for your lips.
Dr. Del Campo laying it all out, giving us some great tips. And ladies and men out there listening, they always say to go ahead and spread that on and always go upwards when you're applying your sunscreen, your moisturizer, or yes, even your moisturizers for your lips too. So thank you. By the way, speaking of summer, Anais is here. Hey there, girl. She's showing us some must-haves that you need to take on these hotter than ever months, and it's gonna make your traveling a breeze. It is time for summer fun must-haves. We have lifestyle expert here, Anais Grouillon, and she's here to bring some of the best items to your cart that you have to add to your cart for this summer, especially when you're traveling, because a lot of folks are traveling this summer. They are like picking up the pace in the last couple of years and like, hey, I'm doing it. So help us do it right.
So that's great because we don't need so much. It's about purchasing the right items, right? So this is one of my favorite items that I've purchased recently, and I tell my clients, purchase this, because if you've ever been to a supermarket with your suitcase to make sure it is that weight when you're going on that flight. Here you can do this at home, so you don't have to worry about taking out those items at the airport. You can make sure that you're all ready from the comfort of your home.
I love that.
So this can be found on Amazon, a luggage weight, and it's under $20, but you know, it's a great item to have when you're traveling.
It is. It's handy, especially when you're already at your destination. You're wondering how much you bought in pounds and how much it's going to add.
Exactly, exactly.
Let's talk about some of these baggies. I know we're seeing a lot of them here.
Yes.
So what's the deal?
This forces you to be organized.
Yes, it
right?
does.
So instead of just shoving everything in your suitcase, whether it be a wet dry bag, which is great, especially if you're traveling with kids mm-hmm. and you want to change them out of that wetsuit to go into lunch, these are great to have and they pretty much fit anywhere. So a nice duffel bag or even your beach bag is great. And speaking of these little bags, I love compartmentalizing when I travel.
Me too.
Right? Because it forces you again to be organized. And if it doesn't fit inside the bag, you shouldn't be taking it.
I agree with this, people.
So this is awesome because it makes everything nice and organized when you get there.
Yes.
Easier to remove out of your suitcase and take it away. So when you're in the room, it feels like you're on vacation and not in the middle of your living room.
Which brings me to this great duffel bag that
yes.
I couldn't believe it was a duffel bag. Let's
yeah.
show everybody what we're talking about here.
So whether it is that you're traveling on an airplane or if you're going, the kids are going over to grandma's house, I love how small this duffel bag folds into. So yes, this looks just like a regular one of these, you know, travel things, but it's not. It's actually a duffel bag. So you fold it out just like this, and you can literally use it, and it fits a whole lot of stuff, especially if we're using items that are going to help us be organized.
Yes.
And when you're done with it, all you need to do is fold it back up and you store it away.
I love that. And talk about being organized and only bringing what you need.
Yes.
This great jewelry case, I love that. You can see all the items that you have instead of stuffing it into your purse or
yes.
whatever it might be.
And then how many times do you overpack and actually end up only using two things?
All the time.
Entire vacation. But you know, it's just, again, it's like, well, one night, no, the one night, maybe not. Just keep it organized. You can do a set of two. And that way, again, it forces you to wear what you packed instead of overpacking and then unpacking that stuff when you get home.
Anise, thank you so much for bringing all these great goodies to our studio today. And now you know all the good stuff to pack with you for this summer. By the way, here's something else that you should add to your summer cart. Dunkin' is making waves this summer with the return of a fan favorite drink and the introduction of a brand new food item. Take a look at your screen because it looks delicious. Coffee enthusiasts can rejoice as the salted caramel cold brew, known for its smooth and subtly salty caramel flavor, is coming back. Also, you compare that with a delicious new donut as well, called the Caramel Chocoholic Donut. And also, they are adding some items to their lunch menu. So you can see there, they have some wraps. We're talking about chorizo and egg, as well as chicken and roasted pepper flavors. Yum, that looks nice. Coming up next, from drab to fab, get ready to be inspired as Martin Amato works his magic, bringing new life to homes in desperate need of a makeover. Sneak peek, our studio is going to have a little touch of his fabulousness.
Hey, we have such a fun show for you tonight. Our Kelly Clarkson exclusive. We're with the star. She shares intimate revelations about her emotional new music and how heartache has led to hope. Then Kristen Davis's filler controversy confessions, how she's now making it her mission to help other women. Plus, Chris Hemsworth is breaking down his fiery Extraction 2 stunts and how his kids have inherited his action hero genes. All that and more tonight at 7:30 on Access Hollywood, right here on NBC6.
Now, we all know that finding the perfect balance between work, family, personal life, it can be a real challenge. And let's be honest, sometimes our living spaces just don't quite hit the mark. But fear not, my friends. Today, design expert Martin Amato is here to show us how to transform simple items around the home. And check this out, he even helped us remodel our very own studio chairs.
Hi, it's Martin. Today I'm going to show you how to make something old look new again by giving it what I call a furniture facelift. Check this out.
These bar stools had definitely seen better days. The white vinyl seat showed a lot of wear and tear, but the metal frame was in perfect condition. Instead of buying new chairs, you can save a lot by reupholstering the seats. Let me show you how to do it step by step. There are many choices at your local fabric store. The most important thing is to look for upholstery fabric, which is meant to be used for furniture and home decor. Outdoor and marine fabrics are also a great choice because they are durable and fade resistant. I chose this beautiful teal marine vinyl to give the chairs a new pop of color. Along with the new fabric, other tools that you'll need are a flathead screwdriver, cutting pliers, a hammer, and a staple gun. Begin by removing the old seat pad from the frame. You can choose to reupholster the new fabric over the old one, or if you wish to start from scratch, remove all the staples for both the liner and the old fabric you wish to replace. This can be a tedious process though, so don't say I didn't warn you. As you can see, I even got a blister. Ouch! The hazards of a DIY project. Cut the new fabric to size, leaving about 2 inches of material all the way around to wrap the base. Staple the center, pull the fabric tight on the opposite end, and staple again. Repeat on the other side. Now just staple all the way around, placing the staples close together. Once you get to the corner, gather and pull the fabric taut to get a round edge as best as possible, and staple it to secure in place. That's it for your upholstery 101 class. Not that difficult, right? The chairs look brand new, and all it took was a DIY project to give them new life. Or as I mentioned in the beginning, a furniture facelift. Since the old chairs didn't end up in the trash, it's also a great eco-friendly project while saving you lots of money. Materials for this DIY project were less than $35, and now we have brand new bar stools. Big savings equals big style. See you next time. If you have a design dilemma and would like my help with the room makeover, all the information to reach me is on the screen.
Live from New York, it's Saturday Night!
Saturday Night Live turns 50. Can you believe it? Next year marks the 50th anniversary of SNL, and the crew is gearing up for a big celebration. They're pulling out all the stops with a grand event, and it's all happened at the legendary Radio City Music Hall. You'll be able to watch all the action right here on NBC6. All right, that's going to do it for South Florida Live, and here's what we are working on for tomorrow. You don't want to miss tomorrow because a local trainer is coming in studio to teach us some easy workouts to get our bodies moving. Don't forget to join us at 12:30. I can't wait to see you then. Okay, I want to be able to do that. Wow.